are at San Diego Harley Davidson, and today I will be doing a demo ride on a 2016 Softail Slim S with the 110 cubic inch engine in there. I'm so excited about riding this bike, and we'll let you know how it rolls, and we'll let you know what it has to offer. Both of their 2016 Softail Slim S's, the battery is dead. So he's gonna put them on the charger tonight, and tomorrow we'll try this again. Stay tuned. San Diego Harley Davidson has a state-of-the-art facility with a barbershop and tattoo parlor and bike storage for a deployed military. Alright, so we made it back to San Diego Harley Davidson. We're gonna try this again today. It's Sunday, and I'm looking to have a good ride on the 2016 Harley Davidson Softail. All right, so it didn't have a S for me to ride because they're having some mechanical issues on those bikes. So we're back on the RoadGlide. But I'm telling you, this bike right here is sweet. It has a 103 in it. I think I explained it to you before, but this right here is a 2016 Harley Davidson RoadGlide. And it feels like a dream. So he's riding on the 2016 Softail Slim. It's the regular model, and we're gonna switch out on the way back. I'd rather listen to the bike instead of the radio. So all right, this bike, I must say, is smooth. You can click off hundreds of miles with this bike. They do have models that have a navigation system. Of course, if you are familiar with any of Harley Davidson models, and you know that they have a signal on one for the right is on with the right hand, and the left is at your left hand. This one has cruise control. It doesn't have the navigation. It has radio, speakers, bags, all the amenities for you to make long trips on. This RoadGlide, the difference between it and the Street Glide is the fairing and the handlebars. The handlebars is connected to the fairings on the Street Glide, and with the RoadGlide, the handlebars are not connected to the fairing. And we are riding slow. I don't even know how fast we're going. 50 miles an hour. I told him I wanted to ride on the interstate. I'm a little disappointed that I don't get to ride the Softail Slim S, but I guess we get to redeem ourselves on this ride here, so we'll do. So we'll take it for what it's worth. Wanting to ride slow today. What the hell? 50 miles an hour and riding the line. So this salesman in front of me is named Rambo. That's his nickname. And the salesman that I've been working with, his name is T-Boat. But he's taking out another customer, so he let Rambo take me for a ride.
I was disappointed I didn't get a chance to ride on the Softail Slim S, but the RoadGlide was just as satisfying.
See what this bike has. Oh man, it's like a Cadillac with two wheels. All right, I don't know where we're going. Oh, we're going to the parking lot. Yay! Gotta love the parking lot.
This bike comes equipped with many amenities. It has a USB charger, a cigarette lighter socket, RPM, mile per hour gauges. This bike also comes equipped with cruise control. You have two bags, nice stock loud sounding pipes, mirrors that work, radio controllers for dial to change the radio station, as well as the volume. There are other models that comes with navigation as well.
Slow speed maneuver.
Pissed off if you ride this thing now.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
I wanted to see what it had. Gunning a little bit. So now we're on the regular Softail Slim because the S model is they're having clutch issues, they said. So they don't want to send me out on a bike that's not safe. Now this one feels a little bit more nimble than the RoadGlide. One thing I will say that I'll miss about the riding on the RoadGlide is the fact that it's has a seat that holds me in place. So I was going to talk about the Softail Slim S because that's what I came here to ride. So I guess I still will talk about it. So the Softail Slim S has a Screaming Eagle 110 cubic inch motor. It's all blacked out. It has over under shotgun exhaust. It has about 80 horsepower and 100 pound feet of torque. It does have footboards and a heel to toe shifter. That bike also has cruise control. And I wanted to test out that 110 engine to see how it flies. But we just do the regular bike today. Not too happy about that, but maybe on they're having a demo October the 1st, so maybe I'll come back then and I'll be able to ride them. It's my first time riding the Softail Slim anyway, and it feels pretty awesome. Nice little bike, low seating height, and see the rocker there, and there's the rear brake. Gotta catch up. Speed limit is 45 miles an hour. Check my mirrors. Looking for blue lights. This bike would be nice to cruise on as well. But that little bump there, I just came up out of my seat. I guess this is an alright test ride, but I would rather hit the 5 over there. Get this baby up to highway speed. But I guess we'll settle for 45 mile an hour road. And this bike does have a gear indicator. has a big fat tire in the front and a fat tire in the back. I don't know the dimensions, but it is a 16-inch wheel. It's good for maneuverability, having that big fat tire on the front. And look at that big headlight right there. If you can't see at night with that, then get your eyes checked. But this bike has a low sitting height. It's fairly comfortable. Of course, the mirrors, you know, it's a cruiser, so you're gonna be able to see out the mirrors pretty well. And one thing about this bike from videos that I've watched, I don't wanna scrape these footboards because it has limited lean on it because of those footboards and because of the low sitting height. You got a big gauge here in the front of you, which shows your RPMs, and or you can have it digital, or maybe that's not RPMs. No, that big gauge is the miles per hour. So 5 would be for 50 miles an hour, because that's what we're going. And got a digital RPM, and then right beside that, the digital RPM, then you have the gear indicator. Got a nice sound for it to be stock pipes. He kept his speed. I thought he was gonna slow down. So, since I'm kind of disappointed, we'll talk about something else, but the more demos I do on the different models of bikes that I ride, the more your confidence get built, and the more you figure out things about bikes, what you like, what you want in a bike, when you do buy one, and so forth and so on. Anyway, this has been my demo ride on the bike that I didn't come to ride. Anyway, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed yourself. So I came here to ride the 2016 Softail Slim S, and it was having some issues, mechanical issues, so with the clutch, so they wanted to take me out on a bike that would be safe for me. So I didn't get to ride the S to see what the 110 feels like, but I was able to ride the regular Softail Slim, and it wasn't too bad of a vehicle. And I rode on the RoadGlide, which I'm very fond of. I got to redeem myself from my last video. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And go ahead and give me a thumbs up if you liked the video. Thank you.
Name of the place, and hopefully my camera is rolling.
Cause I have no clue.
My friends making sure they walking right, cause ain't nobody watch your back, and it's like